So let's go through the feet that come with this machine. First we have A, which is the general purpose, and you would also use that for doing zigzag because of this open hole here allows your needle. Then we have B for the buttonhole. We have the overlock. C, E is your zipper foot. D is your rolled hem. F is for satin stitch when you do applique. G is for your blind hem. R is the automatic button foot. And then we have, you get a pack of needles. The blue is for, it's more medium, heavier weight. You have your screwdriver, four bobbins. Here's your quilt guide, seam ripper, your brush to do regular maintenance with, an extra thread holder, your thread caps. These go on top of the threads, depending on the size. This one would hold the thread from the bottom, and then the red felt that goes underneath all of that in the thread bar. Okay, let's thread a bobbin. We'll put our red felt below the thread, load my thread, and then the thread cap, the small one on this one, keeps that snug. Pull that out. First, we're gonna go around this little silver catcher, thread catcher, underneath this first black cap. Then I wanna get it up into this tension spool. I wanna mention, you wanna make sure that you hear it click, because a lot of times that's the issue. It's not secure in there. Now we'll grab our bobbin and you'll see the hole. You'll go through on top of the barrel from the inside to come out. I've got that threaded. Now I bring it over to the bobbin holder. Let it click. I'm gonna hold this thread. And now as I start to wind, I'm not gonna wind it all at once because I wanna come back and cut this. I stop it, cut my top thread, and then continue. Okay, I've cut my thread for the bobbin. I'm gonna take it off of there. Get my thread back out from the tension. So now I can thread the machine. And these are the steps. We're gonna go through here. We'll bring it down this front part. You'll see number two and a U. That means you take it back up this side. You wanna come around and pull it so it gets down to that hole. If you have to hold your thread at some point in here, do that so you make sure it makes that connection. We come down here by the screw and I take it around the back where there's a little hook back there. There we are. I'm gonna lower my foot and I'm gonna show you the automatic threader. I bring that down. I take my thread over that first piece of plastic on the left. I bring it across. So now it's in front of that needle hole. And I slowly lift this up and it pulls it through. And now our needle's been threaded and you just pull this piece through. Raise our foot. Let's get that bobbin that we just threaded. We want to drop that in the bobbin. You want your thread to be going counterclockwise. You're going to hold this tail, pull it through here, up to the side. Have a little tail like that. I'll put the cap back on. And now I'll drop this foot again to grab the bobbin thread. I'm lowering the needle. I'm bringing it back up. You can see it already pulling it. I'm gonna raise my foot, and you can see that it's caught it there. I'm just going to grab some tweezers to pull that through, like that. And now we've got that done and we're ready to sew. Okay, let's review all the dials on the machine and their functions. We'll start with the foot pressure. So depending on the thickness of your fabric or how many layers, you'll want to adjust with this dial. Next, we'll move to the thread tension, which has an automatic setting. You can leave it on that, or if you'd rather adjust it yourself, you just move the dial with the largest number, making it the tightest tension for your thread. As we move down here, we're at the stitch width, that dial. So you can make your stitch width either narrow or wide or leave it in the center. And then this next dial is the length of your stitch. That's probably in the middle. We come down here to this little icon of a rabbit or a turtle. That's your sewing speed. Obviously, if you're down in the turtle, you're going slowly, but you can adjust that to how fast you want to move with the machine. This little button here, if you press that, you'll go in reverse. So when you start or stop and you want that double stitch to secure it, you use your reverse button. This window right here gives you all the information about which stitch you chose, which is also up here, the width of your stitch and the length of your stitch, and then it has the name for what you're doing. It's always nice to be able to see that visually. Okay, so when we're selecting our stitches, as you can see up here, it's really this lower knob on the right-hand side of your machine that's going to change to those stitches you select. The last button I'd like to talk about is the needle up and down. So I will start the stitch, it'll start in down, but when I stop, it's going to remain down. What's nice about this is if you're quilting, it makes it easy to pivot. Turn your corner and you're good to go. And again, it lands in the down position. I can be all over my fabric and not have to take it out and realign it because of this button. Okay, so let's go through our stitches now. You'll see them up here. I'm going to use the dial on the right, and as you turn that counterclockwise, it will bring up each stitch here. It will give us the number and the name of it. So it starts with the first one as a straight stitch. Let's go to number 2, our zigzag. It will also flash up here the foot that you need for the stitch. We'll move to number 3, the triple zigzag. 4, our blind hem. 5 is the shell tuck. You'll see you change your foot there. Mention the tension. Number 6, they mention it for lingerie. 7 is the faggot stitch. And 8, the box stitch. Then 9 through 16 are pretty much your decorative stitches. So we'll start again up at 17 for quilting. Okay, so 17, we're on the feather stitch. You can use that in quilting, that's common. 18 is an overlock stitch, you know, for your stretch fabrics, like sewing a swimming suit. 19 is a stitch for super stretch fabric. 20 is good on applique as well. 21 is the tricot fabric. Again, it's another stretch. 22 is the super overlock. 23, rickrack. 24, a triple seam. So it's a straight stitch, but it's a triple seam. And 25 is our buttonhole. It's telling me to change to foot R and also to adjust my width and my length. It suggests 4 to 6.5. I'm going to turn the dial. I'm going to try start between 4 and 5. And then my length dial, it says take it down to a half. So we'll, and you'll see the icon for the buttonhole stitch. So I have those. The next thing I need to do is change my foot. Okay, so let's take off our all-purpose foot. Let's bring down our lever for the buttonhole from the back. Let's slide in our R foot. Hit that back lever, and you heard that click. Okay, let's raise it. Insert our fabric. There we go. I also want to point out, we have this R foot in, and in the back you'll see this pink button. What I want to mention is that this R automatically knows to make this buttonhole the same size for that button. So if you had another button in there that was larger or smaller, this will adjust to accommodate whatever size you have in there. So my foot's on the pedal and we're ready to see it stitch out. All right, let's take a look. Raise that. Clip my threads beautifully, very even. Lastly, let's talk about maintenance that you can do at home. So first we're going to take off the plate by unscrewing each of these screws. Okay, we've gotten our screws out. Let's just lift it up. Slide it off. So you'll see that dust has accumulated in here, and that's why you get your brush. Let's lift out our bobbin and the bobbin case, and we will dust out the bobbin case as well. It's a little thing, but it does affect your sewing. So I've got that dusted out. Inside this bobbin case, it accumulates. And I will mention here that if you're using a cotton threads tend to accumulate more lint and dust than, say, the polyester. So you're going to need to check this more frequently if you're using a cotton thread. You want to go over your feet, and then I can just visually see where there is lint and dust inside here. So that's something that you can do that's pretty painless, but helps your machine to run as best as it can. So now that we've cleaned it, the bobbin area and surrounding, we're putting the bobbin case back in, put the bobbin thread in, take our plate, slide that back on, get over the feet. There we go. So remember, when you're loading your bobbin thread, you're coming right and left and in that tension. And then we'll put the clear cover back on. And now all we have left to do is screw in the two screws that went on top of the plate. And then we're done.